Hello there, friends. As always, thanks for joining me. I have a few important questions for you. Number one, are you super passionate about STEM fields? Number two, do you want to spend your undergraduate years surrounded by peers who are fascinated by tech? Number three, are you aiming for a top-notch college? Folks, if you answered yes, yes, and absolutely, then you clicked on the right video, because today I'm talking about the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, of course, popularly known as MIT, one of our best 385 colleges here at the Princeton Review. MIT is one of the best places in the entire world to study math, science, and engineering, not to mention game design. It's ranked among our top 50 programs. As an MIT student, you'll be surrounded by an amazing collection of creative minds, from the brilliant students to the Nobel laureates who will occupy MIT's classroom. Suffice it to say, competition to gain a coveted acceptance letter is pretty fierce. The school has an acceptance rate of just 7%. If you want a shot, stellar grades and test scores are a must. There's just no way around those quantitative facts. But if you do get in, you'll enjoy what students tell us are endless possibilities, as well as research opportunities at your fingertips. You also just won't be asked to memorize facts and regurgitate them. At MIT, you're taught how to think and problem solve. If you ask me, this sounds like a pretty important life skill. Okay, I know I've been stressing how intellectual and techy MIT is, which is absolutely true, and the university does boast the largest collection of science fiction novels in the United States in its very own MIT Science Fiction Library. But don't misunderstand. The student body is far from a population of geeks who do nothing else besides study. Students tell us that you'll find multi-sport standouts, political activists, fraternities and sorority members, hippies, clean cut business types, LARPers, the role-playing game, hackers, musicians, and artisans among the ranks of MIT students. MIT students also know how to have a good time. Undergraduates here at MIT are notorious for pulling pranks, like getting a life-size Wright Brothers plane on top of the Great Dome for the 100th anniversary of the Wright Brothers flight. More recently, in honor of the release of the Avengers Endgame, MIT hackers put Captain America's shield over that same Great Dome. Folks, the perfect combination of nerdy and cool, and we at the Princeton Review love it. And yes, they also party. In fact, their parties are so fun that they often attract Wellesley, Harvard, and BU students. Of course, if parties aren't your thing, then you can totally enjoy movies and shopping and museums and plays that both Boston and Cambridge offer in spades. I haven't even gotten to the best part. MIT has a 99 rating on students' return on investment. Not too shabby in our words. It's also easy to see why. The starting salary for recent graduates is an impressive $83,600. Plus, given the university's ranking on our number 4 best value college's ranking list, enrolling can be a smart financial move. Of course, check out MIT's profile on PrincetonReview.com to find out more. Folks, you may be sold on MIT now, of course, you just have to get in. And that's where we can help as well. Subscribe to our channel for the latest college admission tips, plus much, much more. Thanks as always for watching, friends. See you here the next time.